Hey, so this is part two of the minimal Git server setup. And in this video, I'd like to show the Git shell thing, the Git shell thing that allows you to create a very minimal admin interface for your server. So let's SSH to the Git test server. And Git, what the Git shell is well, it's in the name, it's a shell, but it's a very restrictive shell that doesn't allow any command on the system, and you can put like custom commands on it, so just little scripts. And basically, you will have a script to create a repository, to remove one, to list them, like stuff that an admin would want to do, change the description of a repository, stuff like that. And you can do that with very few lines of codes, and allow the Git user to execute them, but not execute like any other command on the system, so that the rest of the system is safe. So how you do that is you have to change the shell of the Git user by doing a change shell usr bin. When you install Git normally, it should have the Git shell. I think, and up you do the name of the user. And now, if you try to log in as a Git user, sugit, you will see that it needs Git shell commands directory. So we'll create that mkdir var git shell commands. Up and let's set OV and change owner of that to git and change mode of that to 755. And now you can go into var. Maybe man su. Can you su with a shell? Can go user arguments shell. Oh, so can I go to what was it? S login shell. Yes, S. Can I do su s bin bash git? Yes. So I am as a Git user. So the default shell is the shell when you sh will be the Git shell, but you can still as sudo. Use bash as a Git user, and so cd ls and then git shell commands. And here you can put like scripts and make them executables, and that will be your admin area. I don't know. So let's for example create script vim create set menu, and let's bins sh, and so you in the user will sh to your server, and then he will be granted with this, and the only thing he will be able to do is to create and then name of the repo, and the name of the repo will be in the first argument, and we want to suffix it with a dot git because that's the convention we chose. And it's in the var git repository directory, which is the home of the Git user. Then let's name that repo path mkdir repo path, and then let's do git c. The capital C option is for changing directory before executing the git command. You can also do cd, but I'm too lazy. And init bare, so that we saw in the previous video. And so if you do change mode 755 on create, and now I go in another terminal and do sesh git add git test server, and then let's go there. And you see, I'm not in bash, I am in the git thing. And if you try to ls, it doesn't work. Echo doesn't work. Bash doesn't work. But you can do create. And so here, yeah, I created, I didn't specify the name of the repository, so I did like the bare bones script. You need to do some checks to see if the name is valid or if there is one. But let's create, I don't know, Charles repository, why not? And you see it created a new repository. And if now I go back on my machine, I have a git clone. This, but instead of Charles.git, you can see that Charles is an empty repository that I just created. Let's do one more example with yeah, a list commands. That was my example. Lists and same thing. You create a scripts and I wanted to do ls var git ls var git, just looking at my notes, and it can be anything that ends with git. We don't want to list like the git shell commands directory, for example. And that said, because why not git? I want to remove the git at the end, and that's it. That's your listing command. And so same thing, change mode. And here you can do sh, and if you do list, you will have all the repos you want. And you can do like with the sh at the The extra arguments you give to the sh command are actually commands that are executed on the remote server. So if you just do sh git git ser test server and then list, you will just get a list of commands. And same thing with create bar. Now if you list, you have a new bar repository. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's extremely simple, and you have a Yeah, simple admin interface. Now I can show you what I did on my home setup. So for my own little Git server, where I have a command called repo, and this is a polymorphic executable. Doesn't matter what this is, but basically, yeah, it contains it's all the commands, but in one file instead of multiple files. But you can see here. That's I have a like a help, and here I have a create, delete, publish, unpublish, because I have public and not private repo as well, which is easy to do. I can import a repo from like GitHub. I can list public, change the description of a repo, or print this help. But you could imagine having a many more features like this, because as you can see, this script is like 100 lines long. It's extremely simple. And yeah, you can see like the list command is a bit different, but basically the same thing. Import is just a git clone. Unpublish is a bit specific to my setup, which we will talk about in another video. Create, again, that's just what we did with a few extra steps for to set the like the owner or the description. And you can see I do some check to see if the repo name is actually valid. But yeah, as you can see, very small and efficient way to do things. And yeah, in the next video I want to talk about the Git daemon, which allows you to, so now you can clone a repo only if you have SSH access, but that will allow you to the guy that have SSH access to modify the repo, and some random dude on the internet to actually download it, but not being able to modify it. See you in the next one.